Hey guys,
my name is Kayanche and welcome to episode 10 of my Logistics Pipes tutorial series for Minecraft 1.7.10. So as you recall, last episode we talked about how you're able to send and receive liquids using Logistics Pipes, and this episode we will be talking about forestry bees. So let's get started. So in this episode we will start talking about a couple of things that involve forestry bees and Logistics Pipes. First of all is of course the automating of the apiary, pretty much meaning that automatically putting bees into the apiary, taking them out, analyzing them, putting them back in and storing the excess. The next step of course is the part that I mentioned with the apiary, which is the actual analyzing of the bees itself. Using Logistics Pipes this is completely automatable, so that is pretty awesome. Then of course there's the part of actually storing all the excess bees, which I have right here, which I will also demonstrate in this episode. And then just a couple of other small things that have to do with these bees. So yeah, let's talk about them. So like always, I got myself another tutorial world set up right here just to demonstrate the ins and outs of what I want to show you guys today. So yeah, let's just get started showing you what there is to do with this mod. So first of all, like always, I got myself a chest right here with a logistics chassis pipe with an advanced extractor Mark III, pretty much to pump items into your network. This is pretty much your actual junk chest, for example, to put stuff in. And right here is the output chest. This is the chest where pretty much all regular items that are not bees will be sent into. As you can see, it's pretty much set to a basic logistics pipe default route, which will serve as all the basic outputs. Then right there, another line, I got myself a B-Sync logistics pipe, which is already one of the parts that I want to get into today, which pretty much means that you can specify, when right-clicking with a wrench, what types of bees you want to have into this location. So to that, I hooked up an apiary's chest, pretty much say that I only want to store bees. The apiary's chest is pretty useful for that. And then on the bee sync pipe, as you can see right here, you can specify a load of different things. Pretty much what I specified right here is to only accept drones and to accept all of them, as I didn't specify a specific species. If you want to have a specific species in a specific location, you can simply left click on the slot right here and scroll through all the bees that are out there. Sadly, I don't think it works with all types of bees, like it doesn't recognize like all magic bees or stuff like that, but there are a lot of bees out there that you can still scroll through, as you can see. Pretty much there are two slots, because of course each bee has a passive and a, pretty much two traits, especially when combining them with multiple bees, so that is definitely something you want to keep in mind, and yeah, pretty cool. Simply scroll through all of them once you hit the, once you hit Rocky, simply right click and then it will be empty again. And then if you hit the question mark right here, you can pretty much say what type of bees that you want. So either you can set it to allow any bees, only drones, only princesses, only queens, only purebred bees, nocturnal bees, pure nocturnal, strong flyers, pure flyers, cave dwellers, pure cave dwellers, and that is pretty much it. So that is pretty cool. There's also a little button on here which allows you to actually group the bees, but that is for a totally different function that is not really useful right here. Then right here is the actual apiaries. Honestly, this setup that I got right here works, but is not something I would fully recommend in an actual world. Because using logistics pipes for a regular automatic apiary that you pretty much just want to have in a specific location and don't have to bother with it, I would simply use regular buildcraft and not logistics pipes, but that's just personal preference, but I will be showing you guys how I do it right here. So in this I got myself a B-Sync module and an advanced extractor Mark III module. The B-Sync module, in this case, I pretty much set to only allow drones and princesses of a specific trait. So in this case, I set it to pure Rocky for both the drones and princesses, pretty much meaning that only these two types will be allowed in here. I did the same with the other two apiaries, though this one is set to only allow forest bees and only allow meadows bees, so that is pretty useful. And then, of course, there's an extractor pipe right here to set to exclude nothing, to pretty much take out everything in this apiary. And that pretty much means that it will take out both the results of the apiary and the beast that you get when they die. Pretty useful. Then there is the bee analyzer logistics pipes. The bee analyzer logistics pipe pretty much means that when you have a bee that isn't analyzed yet, this will take priority of where to send it to. I simply hooked it up to an analyzer from forestry, which will dump all the non-analyzed bees, which you get from apiaries, into the left slot. Supplying some honey and some power will automatically analyze them. And when you right-click on the bee analyzer pipe, you can also set it to automatically extract on or off, pretty much meaning that the analyzed bees will be taken out of the analyzer and sent to their appropriate slot again. Pretty cool. So as you can see right here, it's currently doing the Rocky Princess. Once this thing is done analyzing, it will take it out of the bee analyzer, find its proper location, in this case the apiary right here, put it in, this thing will start brooding again, and the cycle will continue. There is one thing that you want to keep in mind, which is with the B-Sync logistics pipe that I've got set up right here. As I am using this one to pretty much dump all excess drones that I have, you have to be very certain that this is at the furthest place of your network. If you put this, for example, in between these two apiaries, this chest will take priority over this apiary and will dump all the drones that it can in here and not this apiary, which of course will eventually stop the process as it will run out of bees. Keep that in mind, very important, otherwise your system may or may not break. Yes, keep that in mind. Then of course, like I already showed you guys, I got a basic... why on earth is there a rocket bee right here? That shouldn't have happened. I'm not sure what went wrong, but it really shouldn't happen. But again, like I said, all excess products will be sent into the chest right here. Then I got myself some thermodynamics item ducts to send it into a centrifuge, pretty much turning these honeycombs that I set to whitelist into honey drops and beeswax. Then I set the servo right here to take everything out, and a filter right here to only allow honey drops, meaning that honey drops will be sent into the squeezer, and the beeswax will be sent back into the chest right here. And of course, the squeezer will turn the honey drops into the actual honey that the analyzer uses for the process. The reason why I said that I wouldn't use this in an actual world is because once you actually reach a trait that you want to keep stuck to generate a specific amount of resources, there is absolutely no need to keep analyzing them, because that will only mean that you are wasting resources, in this case honey and power, to analyze bees that you already pretty much know the trait, because once you have two purebred bees of a specific kind, they won't have any chance of getting random mutations. So yeah, not recommended. But of course, it works, and if you want something in your system like this, you can pretty much think of any other situation that you want yourself in your world, which is pretty cool. And with that, guys, I think it would be a good wrapping up point. Like always, if you have any suggestions on what you would like me to see cover, whether it be logistics pipes, applied to logistics, or any other mod, feel free to let me know down in the comment section below, as it really helps both me and you guys. So be sure to like, comment, and subscribe. And like always, I hope to see you guys all next time. Take care, folks.